Hello, good and wonderful viewers of this channel. You are welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time of being here, my name is Taufik. When I saw Outtalks attacks Omoye Sowore supporters brutalize activists like Deji Adeyanju in Abuja in front of the police, I was engulfed and overwhelmed with pity and sympathy for Nigerians. I ask myself, what kind of misfortune and suffering has befallen and overtaken Nigerians? Watch this video and leave your comment at the comment section below. And if you are new in this channel, please click the subscribe button. It is free of charge. Hit the notification bell and give your comment at the comment section below. And as you help and support me by subscribing to this channel, I pray that Almighty God, the helper and supporter of all creation, will help you and support you in whatever business you may lay your hands upon in your life. Amen.
Aye, aye, water run away me.
When I remember the judiciary, water run away me.
Aye, 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 water run away me.
When I remember Buhari, water run away me.
Ayo, ayo, ayo,
ayo, ayo,
been chased away by thugs who were hired to come and disrupt, to come and disrupt our peaceful rally, and we are not even sure of the condition of their safety now for some of our colleagues now, because they were chased away. We actually went to make a case to the police to try and protect, to at least separate the two protests. And we all saw what happened here. It's not the best of policing that we have seen here, even though eventually they did intervene and it probably actually saved a lot of lives. But my colleague is going to comment on that and a few other things. But let's be very clear about one thing. What has happened here today is the clearest indication yet, and the most recent one, that when we talk about the attack, the concerted attack on the public space, on the civic space, the shrinking of the civic space, the attack on the rule of law, the undermining of the rights, and the violation, the deliberate violation of the rights of Nigerian citizens by those who are supposed to protect them, by the state that has the responsibility to protect them, that this is one example of it today. We came here peacefully. We called it a freedom rally. Our demands were simple. We got our information from the media, some of the investigative journalism that you have done. We know from Premium Times and from The Punch, for example, that there are more than 100 Nigerian citizens that are illegally detained in the country. Those are the ones that we know. There are many more, and in DSS detention centers. We're not talking about the police, because we all know that over 70% of people in Nigerian prisons, correctional facilities, are actually awaiting trial because they've not been convicted of any crime. And so that's the reason why we termed this a freedom rally. It's the beginning of a series of activities. Nigerians have to take back their country. They need to take back their citizenship. They need to reaffirm their humanity. We need to say to our rulers, and we are talking about our rulers across political party spectrum. We are not this, because if the federal government is violating court orders in Abuja with respect to cases that the federal government is trying, state governments are violating court orders with respect to cases that they are trying. So Shoreg court ordered Shoreg to be released. The government has refused. Court ordered Jalingo. The court has refused to release it. And it's the state government that is trying them. And these are two different political parties. So this is not about one single party. This is about the Nigerian state and the Nigerian political class, you know, uniting together to begin a reign of terror on Nigerian citizens. And where there is poverty, where poverty is increasing, citizens are going to resist. And we can all see that when there is resistance, it's in the context of resistance that human rights are violated. When there is resistance, there will be repression. Human rights will be violated. And of course, resistance must continue and it will be doubled. So our demands were very clear. Stop violating court orders. Stop undermining the rule of law. Stop your attack on the judiciary. And please release all the illegally detained political prisoners and prisoners of conscience in the country. And particularly, we ask for the unconditional release of the three political prisoners, Shore and Jalingo. And we are holding the state responsible for anything that happens to Deji today, because it was before us here now that they did that.
Deji have been kidnapped.
All right. Sorry.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, against the refusal for the state to comply with the rule of law in this country. We are also very disappointed that the continuous violent violation of fundamental human rights of all Nigerians is also in the increase in this country. We are also worried that there is a deliberate and calculated attempt by some people who are beneficiary of state-sponsored violence to continue to orchestrate violence against Nigerian people. And the example is what we have seen today. The same victims of states, you know, they are the ones that have been mobilized. They will not help them to go to school. They will not help them to, you know, get education. They will not get them to get any decency in life. But they are ready to mobilize them for political violence. They are ready to mobilize them to come and unleash terror on their fellow human Nigerians. So what we have seen today is a clear manifestation of the state intolerance on the, you know, civil responsibility of all Nigerians to demand for justice. Why we are here is simply to ensure that, you know, our country did not go in a manner that, you know, will continue to remind us about the military dictatorship. But what we have seen now, the people that have hijacked power at local, state and national level, instead for them to, you know, follow the democratic tenets and ensure that there's a rule of law, there's a transparency and accountability, there's a responsible leadership, they have decided just to stay away and focus more in terms of massive looting, sponsoring violence, sponsoring, you know, artificial poverty, and what have you. So this is why we say that enough is enough. We must take our country back. We have suffered enough to get democracy. The beneficiary of today's democracy are also themselves, you know, yesterday they were crying. When we had made effort to ensure that, you know, they were safe and protected, now, instead for them to appreciate Nigerians that have given their comfort, their life, to make sure that they follow the rule of law, to make sure that they did not, you know, undermine democracy, to make sure that they did not undermine the freedom of expression, they did not undermine the space for civil society, to demand for justice, for accountability. Because the whole reason why we are seeing what we are seeing in Nigeria today, it is simply because civil society are demanding that there must be accountability. You cannot continue to undermine and continue to siphon public money. You can see the number of arrests by EFCC and ICPC of looters. Instead for the state to go after the looters, they are now going after innocent, peaceful Nigerians. What has happened today is that we have seen some young jobless boys who are victims of the state. Themselves, they are victims of the state. You can see that they are smoking, they are on drugs. They came to beat us physically. As I speak to you now, some of our colleagues, we don't know their fate because they've chased them. And this happened in front of the security. We went to and tell the security to ensure that they separate at least these two rallies, because we are here before and all we are doing, we are just standing peacefully, calmly, trying to wait for the executive secretary of the National Human Rights Commission so that we can give him our demand, which has already been mentioned, that we want government to continue to follow the rule of law. We want the government to comply with all the court cases. We want the government to release all the political detainees who are illegally detained. We want the government to ensure that, you know, all the people, including the journalists and the activists that have been, you know, under illegal incarceration and detention, are released. These are the fundamental demands that we are making, and that we are tired of corruption, because corruption is the seed of the reason why they are doing what they are doing. And we are saying that the president has committed himself and committed to the nation that he is going to fight corruption, and that corruption is still going on despite the effort of EFCC, ICPC. They are doing their best, but some people in government are undermining this institution. And we are saying that we cannot continue this way. Secondly, our country has been exposed to the most ridiculous political space in the world. Everybody is seeing what is going on. For security people to enter court, it has never happened in the history of Nigeria, and it has never happened in the history of any African country. The next line of action is that we have already given the government ultimatum to meet with all our demands, which is respect of the rule of law, release all the illegally detained people, release the journalists and rights activists, and also ensure that, you know, human rights are protected, and also ensure that corruption and looters have no hiding place in Nigeria. These are what we have, you know, articulated, and we want the government, if the government believe in rule of law, if the government believe in protecting human rights, if the government believe in fight against corruption, the government must adhere to this demand. And after what happened today, if the government did not do that, it means that government will continue to put itself in a very ridiculous, you know, manner, locally and internationally, and that we have collective responsibility as Nigerian citizens to continue to remind government, because we are non-violent group. We are a non-violent group, and we advocate for social justice, we advocate for human rights, and we are saying that they themselves, tomorrow they can be victim of human rights, just like they were victim yesterday.
Let me, the next steps, let's be very clear about
my name is Awal Musa Arab Sanjani.
Main mandate, like you have observed rightly, is to protect, promote and enforce the human rights of all citizens of Nigeria. This one we are doing, and we are not relenting in this. I have listened to what your complaints are, and like you appealed, we are going to transmit to the appropriate authority. The National Human Rights Commission has been issuing press statements even on this matter, on the issue of Omoyele Sowore. We have condemned the activities of the law enforcement agents. We have been sensitizing them, we have been training them on the need to uphold the rule of law, on the need to be abiding by the conduct of their activities. The commission is up and doing in this. We have been meeting with appropriate authorities. We met with the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice. We have discussed all these matters in depth, and the government is doing much about it. And the commission will also not relent in its effort at this. I want to find out if you have any written submission so that we can
We came with written submission, but we were attacked by another group.
We were hired to come and attack us. In fact, as I speak to you, some of our colleagues, we don't know their names.
But we are going to make sure we get you the copy.
We also want to thank the police, because of police. they would have killed us.
They came with weapons.
They came with weapons, different attacks. And these are the same victims of the Nigerian state. You know, they have no job. They are smoking in the M. They are all drugs. And they will hire them to come and do that.
It is the duty of the police to protect all.
Yes.
Whether you are doing protest, the basic thing required is that you should be peaceful in your protest.
Yes.
Once you are peaceful, it is your right to protest.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because here, the National Human Rights Commission, we receive all visitors, all those with claims for human rights violations, people who have agitations, we receive them, listen to their complaints, and we take appropriate necessary action. So all I need is to urge you now to continue your protest, but in a very peaceful manner. Do this, it is your right, and we'll continue to pursue the rights of all the citizens of Nigeria. This one we are assuring you.
Thank you.
Your complaints, like we have now outlined, we'll take them to the appropriate authority.
And we'll send the copy to you.
Endeavor to bring copy to us so that we'll also transmit them as appropriate.
Thank you so much.
We assure you this.
Thank you.
And we'll not relent in our efforts.
Thank you so
in
much.
This matter.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I am Balarabi Sabo. I'm the Director of Human Resources Management. Thank yes, the Executive much. Secretary is unavoidably absent. Okay. He's also been engaged in other...